Hi, and welcome to this tutorial on how to create a normal map for an MPFB2 character. This tutorial will presuppose that you have managed to install MPFB2 and that you know your way around it reasonably well. If this is your first encounter with MPFB2, I encourage you to follow the link in the description of the video and follow the quick start guide before continuing. But now for today's exercise. In front of us, we can see a generic male character. All in all, it looks like a reasonable start, but it is lacking finer details. If you have tried using the modeling sliders, you will have noticed that such details are hard to achieve using only targets. Something is missing, namely a normal map. With a normal map, you can fake details without having to have a really dense mesh. In this video, I will demonstrate how to create a normal map for a male clavicle and an Adam's apple. In recent builds of MPFB2, you will find a new operations panel. Here you can quickly set up a sculpt project. The defaults provided are reasonable for when having a normal map as an end goal. We click the button to set up a sculpt project. As you can see, the original human was hidden and two new objects were created. One object will be used to sculpt the details we want. The other will hold a material to which we will bake the normal map and will also serve as the baseline which we compare the sculpt to. As a side note, the subject of baking normal maps is kind of messy in Blender, and there are many different approaches. This is one of them. If you're interested in the subject, you'll find that there are many tutorials on YouTube. Anyway, we now have an object on which we will sculpt the features we want. As this isn't really a tutorial on sculpting, we will fast forward a bit. Again, if you're interested in sculpting per se, there are many tutorials on YouTube. There. A bit rough and amateurish, but it will suffice for the demonstration. The goal now is to bake this sculpt into a normal map. In order to do so, we will need to enable the second object, so we have something to bake to. Then we first select the object with the sculpt and then the bake target. The order is really important. Then we will need to switch to cycles, as the baking algorithm uses raycasting. In the render panel, you can find a bake subpanel. Note that we have enabled the selected to target strategy. When clicking the bake button, we need to be prepared to wait a bit. This may take several minutes on a slow machine. Now we can find a normal map in the texture paint section. What more, we can clearly see the clavicle that we sculpted. However, we can also find some strange artifacts on the image. With the chosen strategy, these are more or less unavoidable in really tight spots, such as between fingers. Luckily, they are easy to remove by simply painting them over with a 0.5, 0.5, 1.0 color, which is normal map language for flat. Now we can save the normal map to an image. Back in the layout panel, we now want to see how the normal map looks on our original character. So we hide the other objects and go back to EV. Note the flat chest here, which is how it looks before enabling the normal map. Again in the Operations panel, there is a button for easily adding a normal map to a material. Ta-da! Sheep details without a lot of extra vertices. Now, we obviously don't want to repeat this procedure each time. So now we want to store the skin material, including the normal map, in the skin library. In order to create an MH matte skin, we can use the Make Skin tool, which is available under Create Assets. But let's do it step by step. We will first delete the character we have here in order to start creating a new material. This is not strictly speaking necessary, but looks better in the viewport. Then we create a new template skin material with a normal map placeholder. In the shading panel, we make sure that the correct textures are tied to their respective places. The diffuse texture is available here since the character had this skin loaded from the library previously. Back in the Make Skin panel, we can now set a sensible name and store the skin in the library. In order to detect the new skin, we will need to restart Blender. However, having done so, we can now create a character and pick up our skin from the library. That was it for today's tutorial. If you view this tutorial at the date when it was released, please note that some adjustments was made to MPFB2 very recently. In order to follow the tutorial, make sure that you have the latest version of MPFB2. Anyway, thank you for watching and happy modeling!